I made it to Salento. It's 5:10. So it took about an hour from Armenia to Salento. But it was kind of a cool drive. It was, once you get out of Armenia, it's like a windy, hilly drive. You go down by this little river, but it was really pretty. So I'm here in Salento. The bus just drops you off literally like on this random street. So I don't know where I am. I'm out of data on my phone, so I need to find like a restaurant or coffee shop where I can get some Wi-Fi, and I need to find a place to stay. And yeah, so I gotta go find Wi-Fi. I picked a hostel. It's this one. It's called the Soa Hostel, and it's like right on like the main drag of Salento. So like this street is really popular. Tons of shops and shops, bars, restaurants, stuff like that. I'll give you guys a quick tour of the hostel. That's reception area. This is a little common area. We have a bar there. Rooms downstairs. My room is upstairs. There's a kitchen. I don't know where the light is. That's a kitchen area though. Bathroom, showers. We have some storage areas out here, some rooms, a little sink, and this is my room. So they are similar to like the capsule hotel in Indonesia, Jakarta. So they have 6 beds in here. You have some storage underneath and a little plug and nightlight. Nice thing about Colombia and Costa Rica, all the plugs are same as American plugs, so you don't need an adapter if that's something you were worried about or thinking about. More storage area here. But yeah, that's the hostel. So it's Sunday night. I'm gonna go cruise around downtown Salento. It's a really cute town, old buildings, colorful buildings, stuff like that. So I'm gonna go check it out, and then tomorrow do a Cocora Valley.
Many hours later.
Buenos dias, guys. I'm about to go to, so my hostel is right by the plaza. I don't know if you can see it, the big church tower. But that little plaza area, I was there last night, but that's where all the Jeeps pick you up. And I guess they start at 6 in the morning, and then they run, I guess, like every half hour, and they run you to Cocora Valley. So I'm gonna walk there. It's a short, you know, 5-minute walk. Walk there, hop on a Jeep, and head to Cocora. Walking down the main street to the plaza. I'm not gonna eat right now. I don't usually eat till like noon or later. So hopefully there's some food up there.
Era tan orriblemente
pronto. So I kept going past the there's like two, there's one as soon as you get out of the Jeep, really touristy, a bunch of, you know, photo op stuff. And then a little hike up the road is another entrance place. Both of them you need to pay. I'm out of cash. I only have a Cash App. I don't even have my credit card because I lost it in Cartagena. So I went down this road, but it's mainly like everyone that's going down here is on horseback, and it's really muddy and slippery, and I always have sandals on. Decided to keep going down the muddy path, where the horses go, and met another guy from America, and we're now in the jungle somewhere trying to find like a better area. We don't want to go where all the tourists are, so we're just following a map that he has, and hopefully we'll find something cool. We kept going up this trail, and so we're like right here right now. You can keep going further to another viewpoint, or if you want to go all the way down and around back down, that's another like 3 hours, the guy said. But I think we'll just stop here at this viewpoint. So we come up this trail, and yeah, you can see some of the palm trees through here, but I think honestly the further down was better views of if you're just looking for the palm trees.
Many hours later.
Buenos dias, guys. It's 7:30. It's what, Tuesday? So today is my last day here in Salento, and I need to head to the bus terminal, which is like a 10-minute walk. So I gotta walk through town here. But yeah, get to the bus, and then I think it's direct to Medellin. So it's supposed to be about 6 or 7 hour bus ride. So let's go. Nice vantage point or vista point from up there. I didn't get to do it last night when I got back from Cocora. It was pouring and it was dark out, so I didn't go up there. But yeah, if you're ever here, maybe go check that out. Found the bus terminal. It's right down here. I had to walk through town. So it's basically right when you come into Salento. I didn't get dropped off there, so yeah, I didn't know where I was going. I don't have cash because I lost my wallet in Cartagena, and so I can only do contact payment or buy something online. But they don't have a terminal here, but German, this guy, helped me out a lot. I guess there was someone that bought a ticket and didn't come take the bus, so he's giving me their ticket because we tried three different online portals. We tried Redbus, Pinbus, and then Flota Occidental, which is the actual company, and each website there was an issue. One didn't take Visa, one wouldn't accept my passport number, and the other, I forget what the other issue was, but none of the websites work for purchasing online. They don't have a terminal here, so he helped me out a bunch. I'm gonna try and pay him back, I guess, maybe when I get into the US, wire him some money or something. But if he didn't help me out, I wouldn't be able to get to Medellin today.
Many hours later.